Alright, so stop trusting. Okay, so let's move on to section 7.3. You're going to need your trig identity sheets because our sum and difference identities are on those trig sheets.
Well, technically the title isn't black. It's just like the thing outside of the title. Next.
Hitter.
Black.
Okay, this is just a big long explanation of how they derive these, okay? And I don't really think that it's necessary for us at this point to go through how they come about doing this. As far as it is, we're just going to be using them, okay? So go ahead and hit enter. It all stems from Pythagorean, okay?
It's still black.
Stop. Okay, so the sum and difference identities. Let's talk about how to read these. All right, if I use what's on top here, if I have cosine plus, then I'm gonna have the minus sign. Does everybody understand that? If I have cosine plus two angles, are we listening?
Yes.
Then I'm gonna have minus. Now here, if I have minus, then I'm gonna have a plus. That is how these work. There is two trig functions in one. Does everybody understand that here? So depending on which one it is, they did not rewrite these, okay? These are just fancy variables, alpha and beta, okay?
Can we use just beta?
Say that again.
Nothing.
We're gonna be putting actual numbers in here.
Okay.
Okay, we're gonna be filling these in, okay?
I like to look at this.
Huh?
I like to look at this.
You don't like to look at this? It's really not that bad. Okay?
What
does that be? So go ahead and hit enter.
It's beta.
Beta.
Theta.
Beta.
No, beta.
Beta.
Okay. All right. So it wants us to talk about a counterexample here. It wants me to explain why cosine of x plus y is not equivalent to cosine x plus cosine y. Because this is what a lot of people want to do. When they see this, they automatically think, I can just distribute that, because that's what we're so used to doing. Do you agree? All right. Well, let's pick a value for x. Pick one. Something on your unit circle.
90.
90?
Root of 2.
Okay.
Two.
So she wants x to be 90 degrees. Somebody pick a value for y.
Root 60.
Or 0. Same thing, right? Do you agree it's the same thing?
Yes.
Okay. So cosine of 90 plus 0, let's see if it's equivalent to cosine of 90 plus cosine of 0.
Now there's no way.
Well, what's 90 plus 0?
90.
90, so cosine of 90.
Yeah, they equal.
What is, and this one's just, I didn't change anything, so cosine of 90 plus cosine of 0.
I mean, it wouldn't usually because of the 0, because the 0 just cancels it out.
They don't equal the same thing.
I bet they don't equal the same thing. What? So look on your unit circle, what's the value for cosine of 90?
Well, cosine
zero.
Of 90 is 1.
1?
No, cosine of 90 is 0.
Is cosine of 90 is
0.
0.
Cosine of 90
is
zero.
That's right, 0. Sorry.
Yeah.
I'm thinking sine. I'm sorry. Sorry. Cosine of 90 is 0. What is cosine of 0?
1.
Does 0 equal 1?
No.
No. So this is just one of the counterexamples of why we can't do this. This right here is why we have to use the identity. Okay, so here was our counterexample. Now it wants us to show that the sum identity for sine is true. Okay, so I'm going to leave my x is 90 and my y is 0.
The sum identity.
Okay, so using that, they want us to use the sum, which means addition. Do we all agree? Sum and difference. Sum is addition, difference is?
Subtraction.
So I have cosine, because that's what they tell me to use, of 90 plus 0 is equivalent to, now you're going to have to use your trig identity sheet, and somebody's going to tell me what to write for my sum and difference identity.
I don't really know. That's a good question. Oh, then you're going to put sine.
What?
I don't know. Wait. Oh, and then cosine alpha.
What's my alpha? Okay.
Then cosine times cosine zero.
Okay.
Plus, it would be plus, right? Yeah, plus sine. What?
Not plus.
Oh, why? Okay, minus.
Minus.
Sine 90 times sine zero.
Does everybody understand why it is this? And that would be the time to probably be looking at your trig identity sheets. If you don't understand why it's this, you need to be asking
that,
now.
Would that be like the second one?
Alpha
yes.
and beta are just fancy placeholders. That's all they are. You can turn them to X and Y. Okay, but usually in trig functions we don't use. As you can tell, we haven't just been using regular variables. We've been using theta, we've been using alpha, we've been using beta. Okay? All right. So far so good. Does everybody understand why if it's a plus here, it's a minus here?
Because they're both on top.
Yes, they're both on top in the in the identity. All right. So then from here, that's when we're going to go ahead and start simplifying. We said cosine of 90 was what?
Zero.
Zero. And cosine of zero was
one.
Minus sine of 90 is
one.
One. And sine of zero is
zero. Sine of. Oh, yeah.
Is that right? So this equals zero on this side. So over here we have cosine of 90. And what did we find out when we looked at our unit circle? What was cosine of 90?
One.
Zero.
Zero.
Zero. Oh, shoot.
Now, are these equivalent?
Yes.
So our identity works, but just trying to distribute like we usually do in other math does not work, right? Like in algebra. That's why we have to use this identity. Okay, go ahead and hit enter. Hope there was another example. Okay. Now, the reason that we do this is why. Is cosine of 735 on my unit circle?
No.
It's not. But I bet there are two angles on my unit circle. Because here's the thing. They are asking for an exact value. Yes, I agree. I can plug this into my calculator. It's going to spit me out some decimal. That is not exact. But if I use all the measurements on my unit circle, those are exact, right? Okay. This is where your algebra skills are going to come into play here. I need to turn 735 into either a sum or a difference of two angles on the unit circle.
Well, that's just easy.
Okay. Well, let's have at it.
All right,
how can I rewrite this?
I'm gonna start with 220. I'm gonna start with 210, I think. Because I feel like that's a good one.
Okay.
Thank you.
Okay. So she says 210, what would she need to get to 735?
525. Yeah, I'm gonna take away my 210. I'm gonna go with 360.
Okay.
We don't have enough.
There we go,
yeah.
Wait a minute. He says,
because
well, we don't have enough.
Well,
because two 360s plus 15 would get us there.
Right, okay.
Yeah.
So he says that I can't pick two from here. But he does say that 360, would you say, times two?
Yep.
Plus 15.
Plus 15. So what we need is we're going to take this 15 degrees. Remember us doing this process earlier in our,
yes.
Yeah. What was it called? In
no.
our symmetry identities.
Yeah.
Okay. So this would be cosine of 360 times 2 plus 15 is equivalent to what? Looking at that identity.
735.
No, looking at our identity, this is equivalent to what?
It's
cosine.
Cosine 15.
Good. It was case 1, right?
Yeah.
So what I actually am trying to do is I'm trying to find cosine of 15. because of the identity and the stuff that we did yesterday, we can use that same process and figure out that 735 is equivalent to cosine of 15, right? Now, it's very important that we use these because some of these, remember, turned our end result negative. Okay, so we've got to make sure that we know how to use those from yesterday. Now, is 15 on our unit circle?
No.
No. But now, can I come up with two angles that will get me 15?
Yes.
What two angles?
We can do 45 and 30.
Good. I can say that cosine of 45 and 30, am I going to add or subtract those?
Sure.
Good. 45 minus 30 gets me to 15. Does everybody agree?
Yeah.
So, did I use the sum or the difference here?
Difference.
And I'm using cosine. So, I'm going to go to my sum and my difference. I'm going to go to my cosine. Okay, and somebody tell me what to write.
Cosine of 45
minus 30 equals cosine 45 times cosine. Am I wrong?
Yeah, it's cosine 45 times cosine of 30.
Okay, then plus sine of 45 times 30.
Good. Good. Okay, so far so good, right? Okay, so now we can look at our unit circle. What is the cosine of 45? What's my value?
Root 2 over 2.
Okay, root 2 over 2 times, what is cosine of 30?
Root 3 over 2.
So root 3 over 2 plus, what's sine of 45? Times, what is sine of 30?
One half.
Okay, so order of operation, what am I doing first here?
Multiplying.
Good, so I have root 2 times root 3.
Six.
So root 6 over?
4.
Plus, what's root 2 times 1?
Root 2.
And then 2 times 2?
4.
Now I have a common denominator, so can I put the things on top together?
Yes.
So what do I have?
8, root 8.
Is that how that works?
No, maybe root 6 plus root 2. Okay.
Yeah, remember these are like variables. They have to be the exact same to be able to put them in front. And we would add numbers with numbers, what's in front. Okay, so think of that as an X and a Y. When I add those, I can't put them together. But if they were the same roots, if this was like root 6 plus root 6,
it would be 2 root
6. 2 root 6, right. Okay, good. All right, so I would have root 6 plus root 2 all over 4. Now, all of those are even numbers, so can I just and reduce everything?
No.
Why not?
Because they're under radicals.
I can reduce radicals with radicals and numbers with numbers. This is exact. That is what cosine of 15 is equivalent to. Okay? All right? Fun times.
I like this.
No.
Okay?
I like this a lot more.
All right, go ahead and hit enter. Let's look at another one. I hope there's another
no
one.
There's
another one.
Oh.
Yeah, this time they gave us sign. The sine one. Okay?
More like sin.
Sin?
It is sin.
Yes, they did. Okay? So they gave us the sine one. Again, if I use plus here, this time they're going to be the same.
Okay.
If I use minus, then it's going to be minus. These are different, though. Okay? All right, so.
I'm not doing the next.
Let's hit enter.
Let's not do this one.
Yeah.
We
can't. Let's not do this
okay.
one.
Okay, it wants us to find the value.
Mama.
What? Why are you guys being so whiny? And my gosh,
this section
is fun times. Okay, so let's break this down piece by piece.
It's not.
It says find the value of sine if 0 is less than x is less than pi halves, if 0 is less than y and less than...
That's the first quadrant.
Okay, good. And sine x is this.
Okay, I don't care about that part.
9 over 41, is that one of our things over here?
Can
no.
Oh my god, who did that to the thing? It's not Pinder.
Who did this?
Who did
Jordan
that?
Jordan Schinkel. You are dead.
Who is it?
It's Miss Alves.
Yeah, it's Miss Alves, and now our door is tied.
Sorry. It wasn't me, I swear.
Okay. All right, so what we're going to do is we're going to go through this. All right. Now,
in case you're paranoid.
She just said that this is 90 degrees, in between 90 degrees, quadrant one.
Yeah.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Thank you. Okay, and this one is in between quadrant one. So basically these are just fancy, no, Sheber, I mean it.
No.
So let's look at this. We know sine is
Martina
1 over what?
Martina to the office, please. Martina to the office.
Can we just plug?
Sine is what over what? Sine is opposite over hypotenuse. And opposite over hypotenuse. Okay? Hi. And they want us to find sine x minus y. Because I hear what Seth is saying, so we're gonna talk about why we can't just plug from here. We're gonna see what we're missing. So, sine of x minus y, is that a sum or a difference? It is a difference using sine. So somebody tell me what I'm gonna write here.
Okay, sine minus.
Nope.
Oh, yeah, it'd be sine times x.
Sine x.
Sine y.
Times sine y.
Minus, yeah, sorry.
Mm-hmm.
Cosine of x.
Okay, so wait.
Can you do another one of mine? It's wetter.
Okay.
Wait, is that correct?
Is it correct, guys?
Yes.
I don't think it is. It's supposed to be sine x.
Yeah.
Cosine y.
It is. It's different, right?
It's weird.
Oh.
So it's not the same. As
gotcha.
Before.
I don't like this.
Gotcha.
Yeah. Okay. So I could hear Seth say, well, can't we just use those to plug in? Well, let's plug in what we know. Do I have a value for sine of x?
Yes.
What
yes.
is it?
7. 25.
9 over 41.
9 over 41.
Wait.
What about for cosine y? Oops.
Yes. 7 over.
No.
Okay.
So we need to get a triangle for cosine.
Yeah, so we're gonna need, and let's keep going. Okay, so I gotta figure this one out. Do I have a value for cosine of y, or cosine of x?
Yes. No.
No.
No, what about sine of y?
Yes.
What is it?
7 over 25.
Okay, so we have sine x and y, but we need cosine of x and y. This is where the triangles come into play.
Oh, well, opposite over.
So I'm gonna make my x triangle. This is the reason that they told us what quadrant it's in. Are my triangles are always gonna be in quadrant what on this one?
One.
So let's draw triangle one, or triangle x. This is triangle x. So I'm gonna use sine of x, opposite to 9. Hypotenuse was 41. Do we all agree?
Yeah, that's a big difference though.
Yeah. So what is 41 squared?
Big number.
Too big for me to count.
1,681.
Minus 9 squared, which is?
81.
Which leaves me with the square root of 1,600, which would be?
Is that 40?
40. Okay. Do I have enough information now?
Yes.
To get cosine?
Yes.
So cosine of x would be what?
40 over 41.
Okay, so I can go over here and now fill in cosine of x is 40 over 41. See, this lesson's using everything that we've done so far.
41.
Now I need cosine of y. So I'm gonna make my y triangle, okay? So I make my y triangle, and again, they told me that y was still in quadrant one. And sine of y was 7 over 25, so opposite over hypotenuse. What is 25 squared?
625.
And minus 49?
625 minus
49. 576.
Okay, and 24. What is that, a perfect square?
Yes.
What is it?
24.
24. Now do I have enough to find cosine of y?
Yes.
So what is cosine of y?
24.
Oh, 24 over
24. No, it's funnier than 24.
Okay. What's 9 times 24? Somebody help me out here.
9.
216.
And 41 over 25? Or 41 times 25? Sorry.
1025.
Yeah. Minus 40 times 7 would be?
280.
280, good. And I'm gonna have a common denominator, which is nice. So I have 216 minus 280. What do I get?
Negative 64.
Over?
Over 1025.
Good. Now I could see if that was reducible.
It ain't.
I don't think it is.
Probably not, because.
We did.
So far, so good. Does everybody understand why we had to do the triangles? Okay. Go ahead and hit enter. Let me see if there was another on here. Okay. So what we're going to do is you're going to do problems from page 442. Okay. So that's going to be the next section here, is from problems 442. Go ahead and hit enter. Well, this was the only, it was not the only section. Interference signals. Hit enter so I can see what else we have. Okay, this is the same thing using the tangent one, okay? I don't really feel like we need to go through a bunch of stuff. This is the same thing using tangent. This is the formula. Go ahead and hit enter. Let me see how many examples there are.
We don't.
Okay, go back one.
Attention, okay. Please. Staff and students, LMS and LHS, on the white long table in the commons by the blue wall, you will find the district newsletter. Please grab one today before you go home and take it home to look over. It's very interesting.
One.
Has a lot of information in it.
Hey,
thank you.
We did it. Okay. This would be 1 over the sine, that formula. Okay. So anytime you see the inverses, you use these formulas in inverse. If it's cotangent, we don't have a cotangent one. You can't just flip tangent. You would have to do sine over or cosine over sine. Okay, we're not going to go over those individually. We'll work some stuff out on the homework, okay? If I need to do that later, I can go ahead and record that one later.